Trump just pissed off richest man in America with a big humiliating boot in the behind. One of the reasons an overwhelming amount of Americans picked Donald Trump as our next president is he because he makes no apologies for the things he says and is no matter who it offends. After 8 years of lame duck leadership, it's refreshing to have a powerhouse in the White House and incredibly satisfying when he pisses off rich people who have gotten a little too comfortable and think they have all the control and don't like the fact that Trump is in charge now. When you're as rich as Trump is and focused on making America great again, you don't care about other people's money who try to bribe you with it. President Barack Obama was quick to take in other people's cash and his presidency proved to be very profitable for him since this former community organizer moved out of the White House and into a multi-million dollar estate after just 2 years on $400,000 per year president's salary. The game has all changed with Trump in charge now, who stuck it to one of his biggest and richest detractors who showed up to his golf course and tried to throw his weight around and got humiliated with a painful boot in the behind. The list is long of people who think they're in power and hate that Trump is, after they tried their hardest to keep him out of the White House and still lost. Despite their best efforts and wads of cash to detract him from his goal, he won anyway and is laughing every day that he's still their president. Especially now that he just got the opportunity to stick it to two men who led the charge against him, when they decided to spend the afternoon at Trump's private golf course in West Palm Beach, Florida, which has also been affectionately dubbed the Winter White House. Heading off the effort to prevent Trump from becoming president was the billionaire Koch brothers, who love amnesty and are big supporters of free trade, two things Trump is avidly against. Charles and David Koch opposed Trump during the Republican primary season and refused to help him during the general election, as Breitbart reports, and they happen to have a close friendship with Harry Hurt III, who wrote a slanderous book about Trump in 1993 that brimmed with disgusting rape accusations about the wealthy businessman who is now the President of the United States. Hoping to partake in a little rest and relaxation, David Koch and Hurt planned a day-long retreat at Trump's exclusive golf resort, which was suddenly cut short when Trump found out they were there. In perfectly humiliating fashion, Trump instructed management to remove the pair from his property and told them they weren't welcome back, ever. Being escorted out had to be one of the most embarrassing moments for these millionaire buddies in the presence of other rich people there enjoying their pricey membership, which Koch and pals don't get to be a part of. Trump proved that their money isn't important to him and no price can fix how stupid these two look after earning this karma when they went against their own party to protect the political establishment. The sudden removal from ritzy golf resorts has become a theme since Trump took office, starting with the former golfer-in-chief, Barack Obama, who also got the boot under the most satisfying circumstances for conservatives. Prissy Holly previously reported on the humiliating event for Barack, who was ousted by other members who don't have to deal with him now that he's a private citizen. Throughout his presidency, the Rockville Woodmont Country Club has given Obama a membership at their prestigious club free of charge, waiving the insane $80,000 initiation fee and yearly membership dues of almost $10,000. But after Obama's recent disgusting treatment towards Israel with his backing of the United Nations plan to give Israeli land to Palestinian terrorists, many Jewish members are raising absolute hell, demanding that Obama be thrown the hell out of their club on his ear. In light of the votes at the UN and the Kerry speech and everything else, there's this major uproar with having him part of the club, and a significant portion of the club has opposed offering him membership, a source told the New York Post. Obama was looking to join the elite Woodmont Country Club in Maryland as a private citizen, but was swiftly denied access by members of the mostly Jewish club, where many insisted that he deserved to be snubbed for not blocking an anti-Israel vote at the United Nations. It's the perfect dose of karma this arrogant man had coming, since he loves himself as much as he loves golf and got shot in the gut with this brutal reality check.